Hey, what's up, guys? It's your boy, the Chief, a.k.a. the Chef, a.k.a. the Baked Potato with Sour Cream, bringing you another episode of Brawl Stars. We're inside of today's video. We're going to be pushing up our Barley to 600 trophies inside of Brawl. And Barley is honestly such a beast inside of Siege and such a beast inside of so many modes that I've been playing him a ton, and I actually got him up to 600 trophies just recently. He's at 598 right now, but if you take a look, him as well as Carl are super close to 600. And for myself, I've sort of realized that if I want to really keep progressing inside of Brawl Stars, I need to start dropping solo showdown, and I need to start moving into some of these 3v3 modes, because if you take a look at my profile, I have 1500 solo showdown victories and only 1300 victories inside of 3v3. You guys let me know your ratio inside of the comment section below, but from everyone I've talked to, from pro players to people on Twitter, it's a pretty weird ratio because most people have much more 3v3 wins than solo showdown wins. Anyways, I'm gonna hop into some Siege right now. This is gonna be solo 3v3, but I'm really gonna start grinding away with a couple of guys inside of Tribe Gaming soon and hopefully be able to rank up to 13,000, 14,000 trophies. And I'm excited to go on a little bit of a push. I actually did end up playing with a couple of Tribe guys recently who were in, you know, the high 10,000 trophy marks, like 17,000, 18,000 trophies. And we went on some crazy like 5, 10, 15 game win streaks, maybe losing one the entire way. And I think if I can just get a good group of guys to play with, and hopefully they can carry me pretty hard, I should be able to push pretty well. It's all a matter of time commitment. And for myself, I don't really have any travel coming up, so I need to figure out exactly when we can throw down with it and hopefully be able to pick up some wins. I'm thinking, since I'm not traveling, it might be time to go for a really good grind and maybe go balls to the wall just trying to get as many wins as possible inside of Brawl. Let's see if we're gonna make it happen. I'll take a look at the season after this, but let's hop into battle number one. Of course, on this map, there are a lot of walls for Siege. Any Siege map that has walls is almost an autoplay for Barley. Barley just has so much control on all of these maps. I'm gonna start throwing in with Leon right here. That's gonna be a dead Leon to kick this off. Penny's gonna go in. I'm gonna hit Penny with two more shots right there. They did get the very first bolt, but we did actually end up getting control of the left side of the map. However, it looks like on the right side of the map, my teammates got completely flustered, and we're gonna end up losing control even after we threw down in the beginning. Okay, well, we'll kill their Penny, we'll kill their Leon as well, so that's two down for their team. Hopefully they don't get the third bolt so we can get this very first Siege. Looks like Spike's going in. Spike's gonna run on through right here. Not enough damage for me to be able to take out Spike. I'm just gonna die down in those spikes right there. So close to getting the job done, but instead, it looks like Siege number one's gonna go to their team. You can see how this works though. If we get control of the center as Barley, if our teammates don't lose their lanes, we'll be able to run in and go ham and hopefully be able to pick a nice win right here. Let's start getting ready for the Siege bot. Siege bot doesn't really do too much damage, especially at level three, so I don't mind taking my time right here. Leon might run in a moment, so we gotta be a little afraid. Leon's gonna run in and just die right there, and somehow I died as well, I guess. It was the gene that got me. Anyways, I'm gonna go and run forward right here, and once you spawn inside of Siege, you are immune for a couple of seconds, so I'm gonna use that immunity to try to take the Siege robot nice and low, and that's gonna lead to us being in an okay position. But man, Leon's already back up there, and we need to find a way to get control of the center of the map. Our opponents have had too much work on the center of this map right now. Leon's gonna take this bolt at some point. We need to find a way to get some control of the center of this map, and that's not going to happen by us running towards bolts and just dying. I'm going to throw down our super once more right here to see if we can do something against the Sakura spikes. Spike's actually going to end up supering himself, and Leon once again, man, I am not getting a break right now. We need to do some work and control one side of the map at all, or we're not going to be able to get this win. We're just continually being pressured, and with Spike on me, I'm going to kill Spike, but we do need to get a little more damage down right here. And finally, we're gonna get control of the left-hand side. I'm gonna take an unnecessary mortar shot right there. I'm gonna throw this down because I think there's a spike coming up. Looks like there was. And that's gonna be some serious damage. We've got 7 bullets to 5. And finally, we're making moves and might be able to do some work inside of this game. Okay, I think they have a Leon. The only issue is when they have Leon go in, it's a big issue for us when he goes invisible, as you guys might be able to tell. So I'm gonna start backing up right here. I have a feeling Leon's right there, but it doesn't look like he is. Let's see if he pops. He's gonna pop up right here. Yep, there's the Leon. We're gonna go ahead and snipe him down, and the mortar shot's gonna take him out. This is beautiful stuff right here. Let's throw our super with Barley. Don't save your super. You guys need to be spamming it against your opponents. We're gonna get Spike down. This is a carry job right now. 17 bolts for your boy, the Chief. We're putting in some work, and this is how you get it done. Zone out your opponents, play and give some pressure to them. We're gonna continue going in on this Leon. Leon is super low. Looks like we've got Spike right here. I'm gonna use my super against this Leon. I'm gonna miss, but I'll hit my second shot. And guys, this is domination. 21, 22 bolts on this Siege robot. This is practically gonna be impossible for them to be able to defend against. So long as we don't die right here, let's hold on against this Leon. We just don't wanna die and give Leon a chance to put in some work. Looks like Leon's gonna back up. Leon has to really back up right now because our Siege robot has so much HP. It's onto the turret, guys. Spike's gonna defend while he is immune, but that is gonna be Gia Gia well played. And that's how you get the job done using barley, controlling the center of the map. It took us, in the very beginning, we had to willpower our way through, but guys, getting the star power for getting the job done, and that's gonna push us above 600 trophies on barley. That's how you do it. You control the center of the map as barley. Try to win one side of the map. Try to win the left side or the right side of the map, and then once you win your side of the map, throw some shots over to your teammates and the other enemies, and try to take them out and help out your team. That's generally how you wanna get the job done, and for us, we wrestled that left-hand side control of the map. We were able to help out our teammates, and then we just started stacking up bolts, and once we got that push going, it was basically GG. That was perfectly done, even with that shaky start right there. Shows that things don't always have to be perfect, and let's get into battle number two and see if we can get this job done. Hopping into battle number two right now, we've got a Dynamike on the enemy team, so we are not the only thrower, and we have two, you don't really classify Leon as a melee brawler, so that's inaccurate, but we do have this Dynamike right here that we're gonna have to deal with. I have to be really, I actually don't always like the barley against Dynamike matchup. I feel like Dynamike, with his really heavy burst damage, has a lot of advantages, actually. So we're gonna go ahead and run on through. Dynamike's gonna be able to blow me up. And yeah, I told you guys, I don't really like playing Dynamikes too often. So we're gonna have to find a way to do this. But we did actually end up getting three bolts right there. So really well done for my team. I think I might have gotten the first bolt, but they did a great job staying alive, winning this combo right here. And that's not traditionally done by a lot of tanks. Looks like Bull is really just focusing on avoiding most of these Dynamike shots. That's doing a beautiful job. We're gonna spam down this Jesse. And look, I already have my super available after throwing it just a moment ago. I'm gonna continue just to pressure these guys and give my team a little bit time to get ready. Now, normally, before Barley got changed and the super stacked up, I would never waste the super like that. But now, Barley's super is more of a zone control tool than it is for like something for doing really serious damage. So let's go and let this all go in right here. Looks like they're gonna start putting in some work. Bull's gonna start running forward as well. And now we can really start damaging down this. Wow, this turret is taking a serious beating. This is really good for us. I was trying to get one more hit onto the penny, but we took it to 45% HP. And guys, whenever you go for the turret, you should aim to do around 45 to 50%. If you can do 45 to 50% at least, it's gonna set you up great for future pushes to try to get the job done. Penny gonna walk a little bit too close right there. I'm gonna throw my super down to zone out this Dynamike, zone out the rest of the brawlers. This is working perfectly. Rice Slayer going in right here. I have to watch out. Ooh, that turret's gonna kill me actually. Leon has to do something against that turret, but I think he was out of ammo. All right, they might do this, and Bull using a super. I'm not sure about that one, but okay, that'll be fine. I'm gonna throw my shots forward to take out this turret once more, and now we can sort of reset the playing field and hopefully find a way to get this done. That's actually gonna be, wow, I think Dynamike messed up right there. Level 5 Siege Robot still going down for them, so this is gonna be a crucial defense, and so long as we keep them from doing like a preposterous amount of damage, which with their Penny dying right there, I don't think it's gonna get done. Plus, we have a Bull, as well as we have a Leon, who have really high damage per second for when we want to put in work. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to avoid even working on the Siege Brawler right here. I'm going to work on the enemy Brawlers to try to keep them away from destroying our stuff. I'm also going to throw down my super and try to just destroy them right here. That's going to go down on the Dynamike. Dynamike's going to get killed right there. 5 bolts to 0. They did get 63% HP, but if we get this very next push, guys, we're going to get over 45% damage. You guys already know it. Dynamike trolling right there, by the way. We're going to completely blast that Dynamike down. I'm even going to throw my super just to take him out to make sure he has to respawn and walk all the way back over. Beautiful stuff. Bull's going to die. We're going to throw down some more fire right there. Actually, that was our Leon, not our Bull. Looks like we're sitting pretty. They do have this turret, so I might need to help my team out with that. I'm going to continue to fall backwards on this Dynamike. And yeah, we're sitting in a fine spot. Dynamike's gonna get one more hit right there. I'm gonna use my super once again as a zoning tool, and Dynamike is feeling the pain. Let's throw down some shots over there. Level 12 Siege Robot. And guys, that's gonna be a GG. Unless we completely blow this, this should be GG well played. Let's run forward on the Jesse. Jesse's gonna get a shot right there. Dynamike's gonna have to run on in, but now all we're gonna do is, wait. What did I do right there? Bull's gonna run in onto the turret though. And with a couple of quick shots, that'll be GG. Beautifully done. Textbook victory right there. And again, guys, getting that control as barley is crucial. Now, even against one of our least fun matchups, which is Dynamike, we ended up getting that dub. Again, Dynamike versus Barley, it is a lot of skill-based when it comes to that matchup, but I do think that Dynamike having that really explosive damage with his two shots is really powerful, whereas Barley, if you land one of your shots, it only does 900 damage, because most likely they're gonna walk outside of the pool. Anyways, let's get into match number three right now, and let's make this a perfect trifecta. Let's go! So hopping into the final battle for today, we've got a Brock Pam on our side. I saw they had a Frank on their side, and Frank, we can totally abuse his barley. However, he does have a lot of HP, so we have to be pretty concerned of that. But check this out. We're gonna use the walls to our advantage. We're just gonna start trolling around on this Frank. The crucial thing is we can't really let him heal, or it's gonna lead to a pretty bad time. So let's just go ahead and let him run out right there. I actually ended up throwing my super and missing, and I need to actually team up on their barley right there if we wanna get this job done. Barley's gonna be our number one concern. Let's start throwing in. We're gonna kill their barley, which is beautiful. Frank's gonna run through. Frank's gonna try to take us out, guys, and even with their base trying to take me down, we're gonna get a really, really nice start to this game, and we can just start throwing him backwards. Once again, pressuring with my super whenever possible. Frank's gonna run through the fire and the flames. He's gonna burn all the way down to zero. This is how you start off a game, and I was about to say Clash Royale, of Brawl Stars. This is how you start off a game of Brawl Stars. You just blast them down over and over. Pam Brock is a really strong combo. Maybe not the best combo on a map with so many walls, but it's still gonna put in some work right here. This barley, gonna be a little bit troll with how aggressive he's playing towards me, but I'm gonna go ahead and let him do his thing. Let's let this all run on through right now, and finally we can follow up over here. I'm actually gonna end up maybe trying to kill this barley as well. I don't know if that's worth. Maybe I should have just gone for the turret. But wait! The turret is taking so much damage. They literally have no one defending it. Brock is getting an insane amount of value. We're going to finally back up, but not before we get slapped in the face. And only 26% HP remain. Now, with Barley, I'm going to show you guys a little tip. I don't even need to do this right now, but what you can you do is Barley, if you ever need to get those last couple of percentage points, you can always run forward and try to get the job done. I'm going to run forward onto this Barley as well. I'm going to start supering to apply that pressure and that zone control, guys. Again, don't look at your super as a damage tool. Look at it as a zone control and a way to push your opponents back. But that's going to be beautiful until I miss that. That was a little troll for me missing the, what was it? I missed something right there. I don't know what I'm saying. Finally, we're going to kill that barley. Let's go. Level 5 siege robot for them, but let me just show you guys the tricks of the trade right here. You can run on forward, and even if they have a siege robot, well, I can throw my super down as well, which will be pretty fun, but I'm going to go ahead and let this all run through. Barley's going to leave me alone, which means I can go ahead and start sprinting towards this base, get all three shots off, and that's going to take that all the way down to 1020 HP, and even though they're going to blast our turret down pretty badly, guys, all we need is one more auto attack onto their turret, and we're going to end up winning. And Pam's gonna start blasting us. Okay, I got a little troll right now. I'm getting a little excited because I wanna backdoor that base. But with 2% HP remaining, as long as we run forward and get one shot onto their base, it's GG well played. Plus, we have 5-6 bolts inside of our backup. Yeah, this is not looking too great for them. And this is gonna be the end of the match. All right, Frank's gonna knows that he has to defend the home base right here. He knows he has to put in some work. He's gonna even use his super. Oh, he's gonna get me? Oh man, my thumb was over it and I thought we had actually got it right there. I wanna get this base backdoored so bad, but it doesn't look like it's gonna happen. 7 seconds left on the clock and Chief Kobe needs to come out and finish this one off. Frank knows what we're trying to do though. Frank is spinning to win, and with one more throw, that's gonna be GG well played. Stunting on that turret to finish this one off. And guys, 3 for 3 using Barley. It's a cheat code using Barley instead of Siege. It's really so easy. 3 straight wins to push us well below above 620 trophies on a single brawler is really nice. Honestly, we rarely push brawlers this high, but I think using 3v3 and not playing solo showdown is gonna be big for us. Let me see which brawler, let me see how high my barley is, if it's anywhere near respectable as far as the ranking goes. All right, my barley is gonna be 281st in the world. Not bad, not bad at all. I got a lot of people up here in the 800s, 700s. I feel like I could definitely hit 700 trophies, no doubt. But once we get to 700 trophies, we'll have to see how nice it is to push inside of Siege. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode inside of Brawl Stars. I had a lot of fun pushing my barley up today and getting those wins for you guys. If you enjoyed this episode, just let me know inside of the comment section below me. Show me some love, as well as hit that sub button with a flying people's elbow out of nowhere or with your cat's paw. Shout out to Chief Cat, who's sleeping next to me right now. That's gonna do it for this video today, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Until next time.